Temperatures have continued to make ice. It's a bit slower than most anglers would prefer, but there are spots that are now thick enough for fish houses. But there are, of course, the regulations that you want to be aware of so you don't get in trouble. Joining us with all the details is Doug Lear from North Dakota Game and Fish. Now, I guess the first question off the top is, does your fish house need to be licensed in the state of North Dakota?
Back in the day, there was actually a licensing regulation and requirement in North Dakota, but it's probably been about 15 years since we removed. So they don't actually have to be licensed if you're going to take a shelter out on the ice. And as you mentioned, it's starting to get thicker. You're starting to see that a lot more common. You still want to be cautious and careful. There's still plenty of thin ice, so you don't need to actually have a technical license on your shack when you leave it out there. But if you're going to leave it out there unattended overnight or unattended for throughout the winter time, then you need to have your name on the ice shelter, and then either a phone number or your address is required. We want to be able to get in touch with somebody. Sometimes there's break-ins, and sometimes bad things happen out there. But they have to be made out of floatable material. And people will ask if I can use an old truck or an old school bus or something like that as an ice shelter. You can use anything you want. But if you're going to leave it out there unattended, then it has to be made out of floatable material, something that would float. And a lot of the newer ones, meet that requirement. But some people like to make their own ice shelter and make their own ice shack. So some of the regulations that we want people to be aware of when they're getting out there and getting ready to enjoy some winter ice fishing, Kyle.
And if you do leave it out there, we've got plenty of ice fishing season left. I know Lisa Green has been talking about temperatures this weekend dipping well below zero.
Yeah, so, it's making good ice, but then also remember that if you get a little bit slack on it and decide that I've had too much, they actually have to be removed by March 15th, and if they freeze in, you might spend some time chipping them out. So there is a removal deadline. We've got a ways to go before that, but that just gives you a little brush up on the regulations as you head out ice fishing this weekend.
Sounds good. Doug Lear, North Dakota Game and Fish, thanks for coming in.
You're welcome.